So let's start with this. This is the trailer that actually made me have some level of faith in this project. And here's why. Look at how much space there is in this trailer. And what I mean by that is they let lines live. There's like a ebb and flow. It feels noir. It feels a little sad. And that's what I want. I want that Blade Runner space depression, right? There is something uncanny about space noir where not only does it reach inside my body and tickle the sad parts of my soul where I'm like, oh my gosh, I'm just kind of a depressed person. I have a bad outlet. But also, because it's set in space, there's this hope for tomorrow. With projects like Blade Runner, there's something uncanny. Let me show you. There's something uncanny about moments like this. This. All day. Right? To this day. Give me this. There's something sad, but cozy, but depressed, but hopeful, right? It recognizes how weak and disgusting and slimy humanity is, but there's this hope for the stars. There's this reach for love and for beauty somewhere out there in the cosmos. There is something beautiful and pure and lonely and dystopian, but also it's everything. Are you feeling that feeling? You're feeling that feeling? Good. Let me show you something. You guys feel that? Now I want you to look at how Cowboy Bebop the anime opens. Does this look familiar? Is there an aesthetic that you might recognize there? That's how Bebop opens, okay? Now, after the credits, take a look at how Cowboy Bebop establishes the world.
It's been a great 7 months, looking forward to many more.
Look how long Cowboy Bebop takes.
Chat Neffle, Neffle, Neffle.
Thank you so much. Establishing space before anything is done or said. Now, I want you to focus on the fact that this is a 24-minute episode. 24-minute episode. And before a single line comes out, we are 3 minutes in. We've established the past timeline. We've established, so much before we get into character, okay? And I think right from Lights Up is where I was like, okay, the new Cowboy Bebop fundamentally does not understand what this project is. And a lot of people said, oh, it's because they went in a different direction. Oh, it's because they were trying not to clone the anime. Bullshit. That's the Lights Up from this. The Lights Up from Cowboy Bebop is, do you got from the live action, do you guys remember? Did anybody watch? I'll tell you, it starts on a robbery. It starts in the middle of a robbery that literally, I'm gonna say it, is basically stolen from a Tarantino film. It's like a Tarantino-style villain and robbery. And listen, before you go, oh, Tarantino, no, it's their own style. Guys, they had a Royale with cheese on the f***ing restaurant menu. Okay, they wanted to do Tarantino style. I don't know why they felt that Tarantino was a good comp for Cowboy Bebop. It couldn't be further from the truth. It just goes deeper into me like going, okay, they had no idea what the voice of this was, but they wanted to make Cowboy Bebop like a Tarantino universe project thing. I don't know. It's clear to me. But they start on a robbery. They start inside. Show us space, man. Show us space. Listen, I'm not going to mold. We're going to be fair about this. We're inside for like the first 10 minutes. Then they introduce a fucking, I don't know, a space gun.
Cowboy Bebop live action.
They introduce a space gun and they're like, oh God, there's a space gun. And he's like, don't shoot that space gun. And the space gun opens up a hole and then everybody floats clearly on wires. Just in the worst depiction of space ever. Not smooth at all. Whatever. Okay. There you go. It just wasn't the right open for me. Okay. And right from the get, those two scenes, I knew what was wrong. And it's what I theorized when I first started watching Cowboy Bebop material. And that is the creators of the live action did not understand the original Cowboy Bebop. They did not understand the sentiment, the themes, the motifs, or the purpose of a project like Cowboy Bebop. And so here is what I am telling you. A lot of people are going, I liked the new project. I didn't think the acting was bad. I didn't think it looked bad. I thought there were some cool moments. And to that I say, you're not wrong. The acting is pretty decent. There are some things that look passable. The problem is, if you are going to make a live action adaptation, and you are going to overwhelmingly stick with the storylines of the original show, everybody is saying
that's for cool.
They went in their own direction. Bullshit. They did not go in their own direction. Every episode is based on an episode, right? They may have made them significantly shittier, but it's all from the anime. Like, it's all shit that's from the anime. And I don't know, man. I don't know. Let's get into some more things. This episode is, I think, the best episode of the entire series, or at least in the conversation for it. And there were certain things about this episode that they butchered. Okay, I want to show you this interaction right here.
You're a buyer, you know the score.
All right, so that interaction right there is like so dark. It's like a real drug deal, right? Okay, we're doing a drug deal. Let me test the stuff. Got it. In the live action, for the life of me, I will never understand, but the writer and the director saw fit to work a moment in here where this character goes, I'm gonna buy the red eye, but afterward, we're going to have cupcakes. And Asimov goes, cupcakes? And the drug dealer goes, yeah, who doesn't like cupcakes? And I just felt myself...
I like cupcakes.
I just felt myself cringe. I felt myself cringe in a way where I was like, why? Why did they do, like, I get it. I get you're trying to do something different, but like, yes. You're f***ing up the tone of your own show. And then obviously, dude, like, this sequence is so sick in the show, and they made it so bad in the anime. They totally got rid of this entire prophetic sequence. Yes. that sets the tone for the whole show and leads to the Space Lion episode prediction at the end, whatever. Then also, you know, let's make one of the most iconic anime Latinas in history a British white woman. That feels good. That sounds like a good idea. Let's not have this clear homage to Desperado in a show that we are already basing things on the Tarantino universe in. But whatever. Who cares? I don't care. And then the other thing is they made a choice to, instead of making her a desperate woman, which is like the point of this episode, right? She is a desperate woman who is thrown in her lot with a bad dude, Asimov, and she's trying desperately to get to safety in this episode, right? And it speaks to Spike. It speaks to him because he's a lovesick guy also. And he gets, oh my gosh, you're in a bad relationship. I know what that's like. And she's desperate. We gotta get off planet. This is so bad. We gotta get out of here. And it leads to this incredible moment where she realizes, even though she's thrown in with this psychopath, she's never gonna get off planet. She's f***ed. And it leads to this incredible moment right here.
We'll never get out of here now. I'll never see Mars. Adios.
Where she kills Asimov. That's the whole point of that moment. The whole point of that moment is because this right here, in another life, they could have been together, right? The hopeless romance of this instant, how you've fallen in love with her, and Spike has fallen in love with her, but he can't give love, and he can't feel love, and in this instant, he sees himself in that cockpit, killed by love, put in an impossible situation. And they have this moment, adios, and he watches this woman that he's known briefly but feels love for get torn apart and float into space after she kills her own lover. In live action, he just kind of dies, and she's like the extremely wealthy heiress of some crime family. Then they, for some reason, felt like it was a good idea to introduce Faye into this episode. Faye just shows up in this episode. Faye is so annoying in the live action. I have to say it. Let's get into it. Oh my God. I don't care who the actress is. I don't care what she looks like. I don't have the luxury of caring because you absolutely butchered the character. You took one of the most likable, like, protagonist, doomed, star-crossed lover, you know, Romany women of all time, and you made her the not like the other girls chick. She literally behaves like she shops at and or works at a Hot Topic. It is difficult. That sequence where she goes to a cup, drinks it, and goes, "What was that?" And Jet goes, "Water." And she goes, "Ugh." And grabs a beer and then, like, has a full body standing orgasm from drinking a beer. It's like, you missed the point of this character, man. She's not a sloppy mess. She's a femme fatale. Please, please. How did you miss it so badly? Oh God. I bet they wanted to cast Zooey Deschanel. I bet they were one corporate email away from, "We're going to get a lot of flack for just making her a white woman." Yeah, but she's so fucking quirky. She's so fucking quirky. She's the girl next door. Beep, beep, bop, boop, up, boom, nutbags. No. 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 Wrong. Bad.
I wish it felt real. Nothing in Cowboy Bebop feels real. It feels like the CW version, right?
And I think that's interesting. I think that was a choice, right? I think it was a choice because it was an anime to take a step back and be like, this isn't an anime. Don't forget it. And, you know, I hate to point to this, but nothing is more evident of how they decided to lean into the fact that it was an anime more than Ed's introduction. If you don't know that Ed is in the show yet, I'm sorry. I'm spoiling it for you. But I'm not really spoiling anything because there's only like one in 10,000 people who would actually be happy to see this. No, I'm making you watch it. No, I'm making you watch it. No, I had to watch it. You do too.
No. Spike Spiegel. Not anymore.
Yes, you are. You're Spike Cowboy Bounty Hunter for Hire. Wake up! I have a job for you. A bounty.
Mine?
Batman's big reward. We have to find the Butterfly Man. Ooh, danger, danger. We have to find Velazir before he does spooky bad things. Spike!
What were they thinking, dude? What were they thinking? Listen. Radical Ed is a very difficult character to do live action. I'll give him that.
Oh, yeah, wow.
And a lot of people...
Biff's gifted a tier one sub to Geisha Main.
A lot of people have brought that up. That Radical Ed is a difficult character to do. And I'll give them that. But that does not change the fact that they went with this. Why? At any point in the process, did this feel like a good decision? Why? Whoever wrote the live action, I mean, when Hideo Kojima comes out and is like, I started watching Cowboy Bebop, and then I decided not to. It's like, dude. Yeah, and listen. A lot of people are like, Spike's too old. I don't care. Spike was decent. Spike was passable. The character that no one is talking about enough is Vicious. What the fuck did they do to Vicious? What the
That's for cool.
Did they do to Vicious? What in the did they do to Vicious? This is Vicious. He's supposed to be super hot. Like, punishingly hot. Like, steal your girl hot. Like, tall, lanky, hot dude. What we got was like, what the fuck even is this? This ain't hot. He literally looks like something out of Harry Potter. Bro, he looks like a fucking Slytherin. What happened? Of all the characters, this is the one that's just like, no. You find Vicious hot, you're fucking right I do. So does your girlfriend. Why did they make Julia like an Instagram thought? Why would, dude, that interaction with Vicious and Julia at the end of the first episode was so cringe. They were like a Jersey Shore couple. He came in and she's like, what happened? And he's like, don't worry about it, BB. Don't worry about it, BB. I was like, That is not how their fucking relationship goes. And like, imagine looking at the bevy of writers you have at your disposal for a project this big and going, oh yeah, this guy wrote comic book shit. He can do this space noir. It is such a slap in the face to anime. Because anime just means that it's an animated project. And I bet they would get the same guy to do the live action Mushishi. You know what I mean? They don't have any respect for it. They don't have any respect for it. They just think it's more cape shit. They're like, oh yeah, superheroes, space noir, same shit. Who the fuck cares? There's definitely filler in Cowboy. Where? What? Huh? Where? What episode? Wait, he said toys in the attic? No. I can't believe you've done this. Bro, let me explain something to you, bud. I don't know if you've ever seen this. This is what's called a beach episode.
Oh yeah, wow, that's very cool.
This is filler. Oh, this is filler.
Cool.
Okay? You want to know what anime this is? You've just watched clips from 5 different animes. Can you tell me where one starts and the other one ends? You tell me. Here's another one. How many different animes have we looked at? You don't know. We're on to number 7. Number 8. Number 9. That is what filler looks like. Oh, need more? Here you go. That's right. Censored cocks. That's what filler looks like.
Oh, yeah, wow. That's very cool.
Love what you do. We'll hope all is well.
That is what filler looks like. It looks like a big censored cock. This is not what filler looks like. Oh, wait a minute. Maybe it is filler. I did that on purpose. Sorry, guys. I had to. I am happy at one thing. I'm happy that the live action Cowboy Bebop will get a lot of people to watch the original, right? People that enjoyed the original that are really upset with the adaptation will go back and they'll watch the anime for a second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth time.
I, Om Symbol, I.
Thank you. And then people that enjoyed the live action might go and watch the anime for the first time. So there's that. Yes. I hope that subsequent animations get or adaptations get a little bit more love. But maybe we're coming to a point with projects like Cowboy Bebop where we will stop getting excited about crap adaptations and we will stop watching things just because they have the same name as something we used to enjoy, right? Sometimes it's hard to separate the fact that just because something has the same name as something we used to enjoy, that it's not the same thing at all. and we have to evaluate things on a case-to-case basis. And, you know, maybe it's I'm part of the problem for going out and watching it. But, you know, I think certainly Netflix heard people loud and clear that even though this show performed well and a lot of people watched it, a lot of people weren't happy.